The winner of the Mercy Hospital Junior Sportswoman of the Year for 2020 is Ellis Robinson.
Congratulations, Ellis. You are the Junior Sportswoman of the Year, the Mercy Hospital Junior Sportswoman of the Year. Well done. Congratulations. Thanks for coming on with us today.
Yeah, thank you. So exciting to get some good news through all this.
Your year, a couple of firsts. Do you want to run us through those for a start? Austria and Slovenia, I think.
Yeah, so kind of the way like our season works is we kind of, it's like Formula One. So there's like a season that goes from October through to March normally. And it's kind of like a series of different races. And it's kind of your combined points is kind of like the thing you go for. So there's like, there should be like 9 races. And they kind of go from Europe to North America, then kind of back to Europe. So we started out with the opener in Austria in October, and that went really well. And I won that one, which was great, which is really exciting because the opener is kind of like the big one for the year. It's on a glacier in Austria. And it was, yeah, it's always like the kind of the coolest atmosphere because everyone's really excited to kick it off. So, yeah, that was really great.
You wasted your knee or banged it up at some point during the season as well?
So before the first race in Solden, we had about like a 2-week training camp up there, and I think on the second day, I had a crash and like quite hurt my knee pretty badly, but I couldn't really walk for a few days, but I kind of just pushed through it, and I saw a few physios from like other teams because I didn't have a physio with me at the time, from like the US and things, and they said all your ligaments are okay, so like all the big stuff is okay. So, like, okay, just see how you feel and keep going with it. And it kind of just got better and better. So I didn't get an MRI or anything, and I kind of just pushed through the pain and kept skiing and then raced, obviously, and won. So I was like, okay, everything must be fine. Just kind of still had a bit of swelling and stuff. But then I kind of got some advice to get a scan when I got back to New Zealand after the race. So after the day I flew back, I got a scan in Auckland and got a ring up from the doctor, and they're like, wow, there's like a lot of damage to your knee. And I think, yeah, there was just a lot of bone bruising, which is like when your two big knee bones like hit together really hard and it makes like an internal bruise. And he said, like, that's fine. And your ligaments are quite strained. So the kind of the more reason they said I have to take some time off is because of the risk of me doing further damage if I went back to skiing like right away. So originally they were saying like 3 months, which was kind of like gonna cut like my whole season out. But then I talked with my coaches, and they used to work with Lindsay Vonn, and they wanted me to see this doctor in the States who's kind of done a lot with ski racing. So I went over there and got another scan, and it had improved a lot, like way more than they thought. And he said, no, you're good to go. So I kind of had about 6 weeks off.
So good you're able to come back and so quickly. And team over at So Sports New Zealand over in Wanaka, obviously you're based in Queenstown, but you have a wee bit to do with those guys over there as well?
Yeah, but kind of like more and more. I haven't really much in the past because I think for ski racing, like we're not, like I kind of, it's not really much for like the same kind of pathway as there are for like the freestyle events. So kind of what I did is, I kind of did my own thing. And now they're kind of starting to help out and send me some physios and stuff, which has been great.
Your sport, downhill and super G and all those sorts of things, it's massive worldwide. I mean, it probably doesn't get the same respect as what we do, you know, in Europe and North America. It's just massive. So do you find that you're more recognised over there than you are back in your hometown, just about?
Yeah, a lot. There's like this joke that my ski company makes. And they wanted to make me a t-shirt that I can wear at home saying I'm famous in Europe. Because, yeah, I don't think people are starting, like around Queenstown and down south, people are starting to come. They're quite into it because it's like, you know, like mountains and things, and they all kind of recognise it. But, yeah, like I see that it's so not a big kind of New Zealand sport. So that's kind of like a thing we joke about a bit, like when I'm overseas, is like how I managed to like get kind of good at this sport, even though it's not big. But yeah, it's really amazing when you go over to Europe and you see how passionate they are. What they all do on like the weekends instead of playing rugby is all the kids go out and they ski race, and that's kind of like their culture. So it's pretty cool to like be a part of sport and you race in places where that's kind of like what they live for. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, that must be pretty awesome. But especially even better being able to come home and hide a little bit. And
Yeah, exactly. That's what I've kind of liked, just being able to come home, and like none of my friends are really that phase. I'm like, oh, that's cool. But like, don't have to like talk about it too much, which is kind of nice.
Obviously, it's in hold at the moment. I think you're ranked number one in the world with a couple of other ladies at the moment, so that's amazing, yeah. Right? You're on hold. Plans, going to keep working out, keep training, and just see what happens, I guess.
I'm just doing a lot of like gym work at the moment, and then hopefully we'll be able to get some training in New Zealand this winter if all goes well and it gets under control here, which will be amazing. I'm not sure if there's going to be any decisions about the like racing scene for another month or something, but I'm sure they'll probably figure something out, maybe like a ski racing bubble, traveling bubble or something, but yeah, who knows, we'll see.
Might even find all the Europeans coming down to your hometown to have a race.
Yeah, well, that's the other thing, there's meant to be a lot of people like coming down to train here, but if the borders stay shut, then that's not going to happen. So yeah, it's kind of different dynamic this year.
Amazing category, just the Mercy Hospital Junior Sportswoman of the Year. Yourself, the winner, Erica Fairweather, who's hopefully going to Tokyo next year, just broke a 41-year-old New Zealand swimming record. And of course, you know Zoe Sadowski's in it. Just amazing females we've got going on at the moment in Otago sports people.
Yeah, it's really cool. I mean, I think Otago definitely punches above their weight in terms of like sports and stuff, which is really great. And obviously Zoe is doing amazing. And I haven't don't really follow the swimming, but like what from I've heard, and Erica's doing amazing too. So it's really great to see such like a cool new generation of athletes coming through.
Thank you so much, Alice. Good luck. Stay safe up there in Queenstown and look after yourself, mate.